So let's go over creating some basic behaviors. We'll just create another app here, and we'll say Angular module, and we'll call it behavior app. And again, no dependencies. And then we'll create two directives here. One to use the behavior of rolling the mouse over the element, and one for the mouse leaving the element. So our first directive will be, we'll say app directive. We'll call this enter, and then return an object, restrict it to A. And one thing I didn't mention is if you don't put a restrict on there, it actually just defaults to A, so I can get rid of that. I don't have to use that. I can just say link, and put a function in here. But another thing I didn't mention is that if you don't, because this is such a common use case, if all you're going to do is use the link function, you can actually just, instead of returning this object, you can kind of start over. Here, let me just start over here and say app directive. We'll call it enter, and we'll just return a function now. Instead of returning that object and defining things on object, I can just return the function. And inside of this function, you get a few things to work with your element. I'm going to talk about the first two, scope and element. And actually, I'm only only going to use the element. So say element bind, mouse enter. So on mouse enter, and that bind syntax should be familiar to anyone who's used jQuery before. On mouse enter, we'll say console log. I'm inside of you. And from there, so our directive is named enter. It's going to be an attribute. And so we'll set up our app, ng app, call this behavior app. And then we'll set up our div with some content. I'm content. And our directive is just going to be enter. So from here, if we refresh, once we roll over the content, you can see that it triggers this I'm inside of you, because it's bound to the mouse enter, it's going to do this action, do this behavior. So I'm inside. And then we can duplicate this and create a leave. And we'll say on mouse leave. I'm leaving on a jet plane. And then refresh. I actually need to add this to the div. So enter, leave, and refresh. You can see inside, leaving. So those are basic behaviors and how you set them up. Again, it's the most common use case. That's why you can do this shorthand without defining that object with the template on it or anything. And there you go.